Understanding the powerful pen tool in Affinity Designer with its different modes, actions and gestures will help you draw any artwork for your own projects. Welcome everyone, I'm your host, Elias Sarantopoulos. So inside Affinity Designer and looking at the layers panel, I have already created a bunch of different examples in separate layers to help you understand the different concepts using the pen tool. With the pen tool selected and up in the context toolbar, I can tap across to view the different modes, or I can tap the word, open the drop-down menu, and select one of the modes. The first pen tool mode we are going to explore from the list is the line mode. The line mode draws single segment straight lines that self-terminate. So I will go ahead, tap and drag to create a bunch of independent straight lines that self-terminate. I will remove those by tapping the trash icon on the tools panel and talk about gestures we can use to control some of these behaviors. So still on the line mode, I will start drawing with a two-finger hold onto the canvas. I can constrain the movement to 45-degree increments. Another way is to tap on the command controller center button and then tap again to lock the shift modifier and do the same, constraining the movement to 45-degree increments. To release the shift modifier, tap again or change to a different tool. Another gesture is when I start drawing with a four-finger hold onto the canvas, I can change the starting point of each line as it has been created. The next pen tool mode to explore is the polygon mode. The polygon mode draws straight lines with sharp nodes and shapes with straight edges and no curves. So I will go ahead, tap and add a bunch of anchor points. And as you can see here, we have an open path, which means we have a line with two endpoints. For the second example, we have a closed path. A closed path is a closed shape with no endpoints. For that again, I will activate the pen tool. I will add a bunch of anchor points, and I'm going to misplace those paths on purpose to show you how to align them using the node snapping controls. Now, since this is a closed path, all we have to do is tap on the very first anchor point to close that up. As for the snapping control I mentioned earlier, up in the control bar, I will tap on the node snapping options and activate the snap to nodes. Snap to nodes will snap any node you drag to any other node on the same or a different curve. So with the pen tool still selected, I'll tap on the command controller, lock the command modifier, and I will start aligning paths together. The horizontal red line indicates horizontal snapping, and the vertical green line indicates vertical snapping. The next mode we are going to explore is the pen mode. In this example, we have a combination of curves with corner points, and by the way, a smooth point is a point made up of two linked control handles. First, I will tap and drag to create a smooth point with these two linked control handles. Before I release, with a four-finger hold onto the canvas, I can change the starting point, which will allow me to reposition the anchor point. Now, by just using a two-finger modifier, I will constrain the control handles to 45-degree increments. I can do the same using the command controller by locking the shift modifier and constrain the movement to 45-degree increments. The following point is a corner point with no directional handles. All I have to do is just tap once and create one. Now, the upcoming point is a smooth point, so we need to get the control handle out of this anchor point. In this case, I will use the command controller to lock the option modifier, change the direction of the control handle, and also add a one finger hold to constrain the control handle to 45 degree increments. Now, this is known as a cusp point, where two control handles are not locked into alignment to each other, forcing the node into a sharp point. The next point, once again, is a corner point without directional handles. So I'm just going to tap once and create one. Next, we have a curve coming up. So to get the handle out of it, I would just use the command controller to lock the option and shift modifiers, change the direction of the control handle, and constrain the movement to 45 degree increments. I will release the modifiers in the command controller and tap once to create the last corner point. In this next example, we have a combination of curves with straight lines. So let's see how that works. Still with the pen tool active, I would tap and drag to create the first smooth point with two linked control handles, using a two-finger modifier to keep the handles straight, and release. The upcoming point is also a smooth point, so I will create that using a two-finger hold to constrain the movement and draw the curve. Next, we have a corner point, so I will get the help of the command controller by locking the option and shift modifiers. From the last anchor point, I will pull out a control handle. I'll tap and drag, change its direction, go right across, and tap and drag to create a cusp point as covered on the previous example. Since a curve is coming up with only the shift modifier active, I'll go right across and create the next curve. Once again, we have a straight segment, so with the option and shift modifiers active, I'll get the control handle out, I'll tap and drag, change its direction, go right across, and tap and drag to create a cusp point. So now I will release all modifiers, go right across to create the curved path by using a two-finger hold onto the canvas to constrain the movement. Alright, so now that you are familiar with pen tool gestures and modifiers, here's another example: curves with corner points. With the pen tool active, I will create the first smooth point with two linked control handles and release. Then I will go right across and create another smooth point. Now with the option modifier active, I'll tap on the last anchor point, add a one finger hold to keep a straight line, and change the direction of the handle. I will release all modifiers, tap and drag to create the curve using a two-finger hold. Still with the command controller and with the option and shift modifiers active, I'll tap on the last anchor point and change the direction of the control handle. With only the shift modifier active, I'll tap and drag to create the curve. And for this last part, with both the option and shift modifiers active, I'll tap on the last anchor point and change the direction of the handle. Now, with only the shift modifier active, I'll tap and drag to create the curve. The next pen tool mode we are going to examine is the smart mode. The smart mode would automatically create curves for you. Nice flowing line shapes, as smooth as possible. In this example, I will just add three anchor points. One in the middle of the heart contour shape, one to the right, and one at the bottom. So I will go ahead, grab the node tool, and notice when I tap on each of the nodes formulating the curve, the control handles appear, giving us full control shaping the heart. Still with the node tool active, I'll tap to select one node at a time, adjust its control handle accordingly, and formulate the heart shape using the smart mode. Now let's talk about some actions to manipulate curves and points. So I'll go ahead, grab the move tool, select the existing path, I'll turn on snapping, and with a three-finger hold, I'll duplicate it and bring it to the other side. So now under the transformations, I'll also flip this horizontally. So the next step is to join those two paths to make them one curve using the join commands. So inside the layers panel, I'll swipe to the right to select both paths. I'll grab the node tool, marquee select these two endpoints, and up in the control bar, I'll use the join command. I'll do the same for the bottom two anchor points, marquee select both, and join them as well. And now we have connected two separate curves together to make one curve. Now let's talk about the break and the close curve action. With the pen tool still active, I'll tap and drag to create a smooth point and go right here to create a nice and smooth curve path. I'll release everything, and with the option and shift modifiers active, I'll tap and drag on this last anchor point to change the direction of the control handle. I'll release the option modifier and go right across here and tap once to create the straight line. Now, in order to break the curve, I grab the node tool, I select this node, and up in the control bar, I'll go ahead and use the break command. The break command splits the nodes into two anchor points, one for this line and one for the other line. So I go ahead, marquee select these two nodes with the node tool, and I'm also looking inside the layers panel to make sure both of these curves are selected. And once again, I'll go ahead and join those two nodes. Now, in order to close this curve, all I have to do is just tap on the very last node here, and then up again on the control bar, I'll tap on the close command, which joins the start and end nodes to create an enclosed shape. Other great actions to talk about is the split and reverse actions. So I'll go ahead and create a nice and smooth curve, like so, and release. I grab the node tool, I'll select this node, and up in the control bar, I'll go ahead and split the curve. Split adds a new node at the midpoint of the currently selected node, depending on the current curve orientation. Now, the current orientation is indicated by the red line at the end node. I can also reverse the curve by using the reverse action to change the curve orientation. And then once again, I use the split commands to split the curve, adding a new node at the midpoint of the currently selected node. Now, the orientation is changed as indicated by the red line at the beginning node. The preserve selection keeps the previously drawn curves selected so that their nodes and geometry can be more easily snapped to as you draw additional curves. So with the pen tool selected, I'm just going to create a simple shape here. And without the preserve selection active, I start creating an additional shape. Notice as I do, I lose all reference in terms of nodes and their placement from the previous shape. So I'll go ahead and remove that shape here, the second one, and activate the preserve selection on the shape here. And I'll start drawing again the second shape. And as I do, notice that I can see the nodes of the previous shape, and I can continue drawing in reference to that. The Add to Curves creates additional curves on the same layer as the initial curve. So with the pen tool active, I'll go ahead and create the first shape, and then go ahead and create another shape. And looking inside the layers panel, as you can see, we have two curves. So I'll go ahead and remove the second curve, and then activate the Add Curves. and then continue drawing the second shape. Then looking again inside the layers panel, the second path was drawn in the same layer, and we can also see that by applying a fill color.